Boxing coach Kevin Cunningham, one of the best coaches in the world, posted this, and he started a whole debate around it. And I'm going to touch on this for a second. Sources say the Tyson pay-per-view did over 1 million buys. Could be 1.2, as high as 1.5 million. So Kevin Cunningham, the coach, is asking, so a fight between two over 50-year-old former champions drew bigger than any matchup between current champions, a clear indicator that there is a lack of star power in the sport. Do promoters need to promote better, or is it the fighters that they need to market themselves better? And the answer to everything is yes. But also, you have to understand that people watch people they know. You can't put on a sporting event, and if they don't know anybody that's participating, they're not going to participate. So yes, fighters have to build up their brand. It's marketing. If Broner, Gervonta, Ryan Garcia, Jake Paul fight, their fan base knows. And every fighter that I just mentioned has millions of fans. Same goes with Canelo, Mayweather, Pacquiao. But there are not a lot of boxers that have millions of fans. So they definitely have to work on their ability to market themselves. And promoters, they need to start getting, just like MMA fighters, just like Nate Diaz was on the Jimmy Kimmel show. You have to start putting boxers on these mainstream shows, whether it's Ridiculousness on MTV, whether it's The Late Show, The Morning Show, just as guests. Not 2 days before their fight, when their face is all, you know, sucked in and they have no energy and no personality and they just want to get to the weigh-in and get over with and get to fight night. Take him when there's no fight or when a fight is just announced, when they're relaxed, before they go into camp. I just market their personalities. Every fighter has a story. There's not one fighter that I know that doesn't have an amazing life story. They all do. And you could put those stories on a late night show, in the morning news. You could put them on different talk shows. So there are ways to market, but it's a combination. The fighters have to make themselves available and put themselves out there too. No one's going to promote you like you. That's a rule of thumb. If I wasn't promoting myself like I do, no one else would. People say, oh, great job, great job. But you have to hustle and you have to do it yourself. When you get big enough, things just happen by themselves. But that's only when you get big. You can't expect that. So fighters have to think how they can market themselves better. And promoters have to think like, we have to make the guy stars. And I know the risk when you make a fighter too big of a star, he may outgrow his promoter. He may go somewhere else. It's just part of the game. You have to risk it. Sometimes, I remember in the past, I would have managers tell me not to interview their fighters because they didn't want their fighters to get famous. They didn't want their fighters to get sponsors. They just wanted their fighters to get the money they get from HBO, and that's it. And if I would interview them and they became really famous, they would want more money. They would maybe look elsewhere. So there's a reason why a lot of it is the way it is. And then one comment, someone said, like, boxing is its own worst enemy sometimes. Like, a fight between Spence and Crawford should happen. And the fact that it will never happen is just not good for the sport. Because people want great fights. People want great storylines. And if you put great fights, the viewership will be there. If you put two guys that everyone loves, the fans will come. If you build it, they will come. But I want to know from you guys, what's your take on this? Do you think promoters need to promote better? Do you think fighters need to promote better? How do you create more stars in boxing? Because there's a whole generation of young fighters coming up that are going to be superstars. Let me know. You have Virgil Ortiz and you have Jerron Ennis and you have Gervonta and Tank. And, I mean, that is Tank, Gervonta Davis and Leo and Ryan Garcia and Devin Haney and Shakur Stevenson and so many great fighters. Alexis Espino is only 19. You have so many fighters that are just 19, 20, 20. David Benavidez is 23, and so on and so forth. So the sport does have tremendous talent, and they're getting popular. But maybe Mike Tyson is right. Maybe YouTube boxing is the answer to bring in the new eyeballs. So I know everyone in boxing was criticizing it, but people who listen to radio criticize about the TV, you know, and so on and so forth. So there's always going to be the next level that's change, and no one likes change. But there you have it. Elisek back reporting.